GreensideDawah.org/donate.
All people of the world, can we spare a little justice? Can we spare a little peace for the children of war?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful All praise is due to Allah And may His peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Indeed, the best of speech is a book of Allah And the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam I begin by greeting all my brothers and sisters saying Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu May the peace and the blessings and the mercy of Allah be upon all of you and once again thank you very much for joining us in our discussion to the idea that in Islam faith by itself is not really good enough that faith must be coupled with action and in the few episodes that we have coming up inshallah we will be discussing an important subject and that is the notion and the idea of relationship how do we relate to those who are around us in the different capacity that we relate to them, be it our parents, be it our relatives, be it the siblings, be it the friends, be it the neighbors, be it the society that we live in, or be it humanity in general. However, before we discuss that concept to begin with, we must look into the bigger picture. And the bigger picture is considering and concerning man, human beings. What is my way or what are my attitudes in looking into my fellow human beings, my brothers and sisters in humanity. And before this, please let us remind each other again that in Islam, faith on its own is not of much consequence. That faith must be put into action. And the actions must be a demonstration, a manifestation of what it is that we claim that we believe in. And that is why it was once beautifully said, if what you believe in does not impact how you behave, then what you believe in is not important. So, it is important. We will demonstrate this, inshallah, by our actions. Our actions usually come in the form of relationships, like we said. And most of our relationships are really with other human beings. We have a relationship with our Creator, and then we have a relationship with His creation. Be they people, be they animals, be they the planet, be they the plants, whatever it is. But for right now, inshallah, we will be discussing our relationship with fellow human beings. And we said before we discuss the dynamics of these relationships, we have to look into what does the Quran teach about our fellow human beings? Because how I relate to them is a manifestation of what do I think of them. And that is why before we discuss the details, let's look into the bigger picture. And how man is honored in the Quran for the mere fact that he is man. Allah says in Surah Al-Isra, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ And indeed we have honored all the children of Adam. Muslims, non-Muslims, men, women, young, old, poor, rich, you name it. For the mere fact that a person is a human being, he is entitled to a share of that verse. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ Indeed, we have honored all the children of Adam alayhi salam. And remember, this idea of Bani Adam is one way of saying that all human beings. And that's a beautiful way of saying it because we are also indicating equality. We're all the children of Adam. Nobody is really better than the other person. Nobody is superior. In the makeup of human beings, there is really no superiority. So how does the Quran go about demonstrating that nobility or how man was honored? In the Quran, it says that man was created by the hands of God. Now, this is really nice and this is really beautiful. that man is so important that he was actually created by the hands of God. Now, be this metaphorical, be it literal, that Allah has, you know, these hands that are befitting to His Majesty, that is really not the point. The point is that this creation, this being is so important and they are so beautiful that Allah said that they were created by His own hands. And that is why when all the angels and those who were present were invited and commanded to prostrate to this new creation, Adam alayhi salam, everybody did it, with the exception of Shaitan. And then Allah asks Shaitan, asks the devil, a very clear question. And that is, مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدْ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْ? Who or what has prevented you from prostrating to the one that I have created with my own hands? Don't you get it? There is so much that is said about man in this, and that is, this being is created by the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is really remarkable. So man, in the very beginning of man, we do not view man as filthy or as unclean or as something that is not important. No, but rather we view man as something that is so beautiful that it was created by the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the hands of Allah do not make anything that is bad or terrible. And by the way, that is why in Islam, we do not believe in the concept of the original sin. And as you know, regardless of where the original sin comes from, Adam and Eve, so it is believed in other denominations, especially in some denominations of Christianity. What is beautiful is that in Islam, the original sin, of course, it does not exist. But even when you ask, you know, Christians as to where is the original sin, people say that it is in our being, it is in our nature. And there is nothing that you can do to get rid of this original sin. And that's why you need to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And through the acceptance and the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, your original sin is taken care of. Well, in Islam, 2 points here. Number one, sins are not inherited. They can only be committed by the individual. وَلَا تَزِرُ وَزِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. And no soul shall carry the burden of another soul, be it your parent, be it your children, whoever it is. He said, no soul shall carry the burden of another soul, but rather everybody carries their own burden. But even more remarkable is point number two. And that is, in Islam, man is actually born sinless. And when man sins, he does not taint his being, but rather he taints his character. His character is of his own making, is of his own choice, is of his own molding. But his being is made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is why his being is forever clean. And man cannot taint his being, but man has absolute power in what they want to do with their character. And we do sometimes, unfortunately, taint our character. But our being itself is never tainted, because it is part of that beautiful creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now imagine that the next time that I meet a person, I look at them and I say, subhanallah, this is the creation of God's hands. And I can really say that because that's what the Quran taught. خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْ. I created this man, this being, with my own hands. How dare you violate that man? How dare you undermine that man? How dare you do anything wrong to this creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created with His own hands? It is only if we are to reflect upon these points that many of the problems that we have with our fellow human beings, especially when we violate them, they will be resolved once we understand where it is that they came from and how noble they are in the estimation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember this, we are all equal. Muslims, non-Muslims, Hindus, Buddhists, Jews, Christians, rich, poor, men, women, you name it, we are all equal in this so far. The next point regarding the nobility of man, since Allah created man, He just did not create him in any way, shape, or form, but rather Allah gives two descriptions about man. and says, خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Indeed, we have created man in the best of shapes, in the best of forms. And that is why Allah said that He created man. And then He said, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ, if I straighten him up, or when I put him in that upright position, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي, and I breathed into him breath that is of my own creation, he said, فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. At that point, fall down and prostrate to this new creation of mine. So here, this is beautiful, subhanAllah. And that is the idea. This is the making of the hands of God. And not only that, but the hands of God made, and the hands of God made that which is very beautiful. خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. We created man in the best of forms. We created him and her in the best of shapes. Now imagine that this is the creation of God, created with the hands of God. Again, be it metaphorical or be it literal, that's not really the point of this discussion. And then it was created, and then it was also created in the best of forms, since this is the work of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine if we keep thinking this every time we meet our fellow human being, and these are the type of thoughts that come to our mind, then imagine how good we would be to each other. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demonstrated this so beautifully. It said that one time he was sitting down when there was a funeral procedure that was walking in front of him. So out of respect, he stood up. And when he stood up, some of the people sitting next to him, they said, you know, Prophet of Allah, we just wanted you to know that this is a Jew that just passed away. And the Prophet ﷺ looked at them and he said, أَوَلَيْسَتْ نَفْسًا? Is it not a soul? Is it not the making of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Was it not created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Meaning that for the mere fact, is that beautiful creation of Allah, it deserves all of our respect. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, paid his respect by doing what? By getting up, you know, as it was walking by him. There is more to be said about this topic, inshallah. We're going to take a short break and we will be back. So please do stay tuned. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praises due to Allah. And may His peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And once again, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May the peace and the blessings and the mercy of Allah be upon all of you. And thank you for joining us into this part of our episode, Faith in Action. And if you just joined us, we're talking about the concept of relationships. And we said that relationships with other creation, mainly at this point we're talking about our fellow human beings, is really based on the whole notion of what is our attitude, what are our thoughts regarding human beings. And we said that throughout the Quran, man is honored. Specifically, it said, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Indeed, we have honored all the children of Adam. And then the Quran goes on into some of these details as to how man has been honored and deemed to be a noble creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We said that he was physically created by the hands of Allah. Allah said in the Quran, خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْ. I created this being with my own two hands. And whether, again, that is metaphorical or physical, that is really not the point, or literal, that is really not the point of this discussion. And then we also said that man was created by the hands of God and was created in the best of forms, فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. And now we want to continue to see how else was man honored in the Quran. And we see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed intellect upon man. And that is part of that blessing, and that is part of that beautification that took place in the creation of man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He has created for us as-sam'a wal-absara wal-af'ida, hearing, seeing, and then said He created for us fu'ad. And most likely they say that, the scholars say that fu'ad is in reference to intellect. intellectual abilities. And then Allah said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, so that you may be grateful and show your gratitude and appreciation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by facilitating and by blessing you with these faculties by which we acquire knowledge. And that is part of how man has been honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran does not stop here as well. It goes on to tell us that also part of how man was honored by Allah is the fact that Allah has facilitated for the sake of man the entire earth and facilitated for him some of what is up in heaven. Subhanallah. Inna zayyanna as-samaa'a ad-dunya bimasabiha waja'alna. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed, we have zayyanna, we have beautified this lower heaven bimasabih, by these lamps, so that when we look up there, we see that it is beautiful. It was beautified for us. Allah said, هُوَ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. It is He who created for you all that is on earth. سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرِ, He has facilitated for you the sun and the moon. سَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارِ, He has facilitated for you all the rivers. He has facilitated for you, subhanallah, all these things. What for? It said that it was done لَكُمْ. And in Arabic, the preposition lam has a meaning. Some people said that lakum means for your sake. Allah has facilitated this for your sake. And beautifully also, they say that the word sakhara, to facilitate, was not or without waiting for a return. Meaning that I facilitate, sometimes we do facilitate, but there is something that we anticipate, that we are somehow going to benefit from what we just facilitated. Not if you use the word sakhara. The word sakhara in Arabic indicates that you do, and you do so only for the benefit of the others, and there is absolutely nothing that you will gain in return for this. So Allah, for example, in Surah Ibrahim, uses the word sakhara at least 4 times, and everything is done so for the sake of man. The way the earth is created, gravity and the loss of gravity, the air, the water, everything is said, Allah, is being facilitated for the sake of man. And that is another indication that man is indeed honored in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then also, not only there, but also Allah clearly said that we have preferred man over many of our creation. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. And then Allah said that indeed we have honored all the children of Adam alayhi salam. وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. And we have carried them, or we have facilitated for them means of transportation, be it on sea, be it on land. And then Allah said, فَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ كَثِيرٍ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. And indeed, we have preferred them over many of our creation, tafdila, with preference. And the scholars have a discussion as to who is better than man. And they don't say this out of arrogance, but rather man is mentioned so beautifully in the Quran to the point that they ask, on who is preferred by Allah over man? Some people said they are the angels. And some others said, if they are the angels, if the angels are preferred over man, then why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked the angels to prostrate to Adam, even though Adam was man and he was not an angel? So that is an indication that man is better than the angels. Not to really get into that discussion, but some people actually argue that man is preferred by God over the angels. Because angels, as we are taught in the Quran, have no sense of choice. They cannot choose. They are made to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Man was given that choice. So if man was given that choice and he obeys willingly out of choice, then he said that at that point, this kind of man is indeed preferred by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over many of his creation that may include in them angels as well. And then finally, also this idea of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preparing heaven for the sake of man. That is really nice. Now the idea is not necessarily just the reward part of it, but the whole idea is the importance of man and how potentially noble is man in the estimation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Created him with his own hands, created him in the best of forms, bestowed upon him intellect, preferred him over many of the rest of creation, and facilitated for him everything that is created, be it on earth or be it in parts of heaven. And now, subhanAllah, it said that, and also for man, when man lives his life and leads his and her life according to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has prepared for them heavens as well. And that is nice. And that is really beautiful. That is beautiful. Because Allah is saying that we not only facilitate for man on this earth, but also we are facilitating for man in the hereafter. And we are going to give him reward in abundance to the point that it is بغير حساب, without any account. So now, when we think about our relationships, if we are able to remember these points, every time that we think about our fellow human being, that will really make the dynamics of our relationships very different. Respect will be more. Love will be more. Care will be more. Sympathy will be more. Concern is going to be more. Why? For the sake of this beautiful creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why it is said that one time Ali ibn Abi Talib, the fourth caliph, the khalifa, he was once passing by when he saw, you know, one person abusing somebody else verbally. And Ali was moved as to how can somebody be verbally abusive of this beautiful creation of Allah. So he looked at him, and the abuser was Muslim. And Ali ibn Abi Talib looked at him and he said, Ya hadha, innahu wa in lam yakun musliman, fa innahu naziruka fil khalq. He said, listen, he may not be a Muslim, even if he is not a Muslim, he is your equal in creation. And that is really nice. He is reminding him that you are not necessarily or by default or because of your faith any superior to this person, because you are his equal in humanity, in the way that we all relate to each other and in the way that we relate to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, do not deem yourself to be so special, because you are not. He is your equal. Pay attention to this and do not be abusive of your fellow human beings. We have this in mind and we will have a much better planet. A planet where we do not practice dehumanization of each other. We are all being honored and deemed to be noble creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.